Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today we're diving into Apple Reminders and giving you a getting starting guide into how you can use Apple Reminders to your advantage. Now, to be fair, Apple Reminders is one of those experiences that is normally sort of neglected because of all of the other third-party solutions out there with much better design. But as you can see here, design's not too bad and it's added some additional abilities in iOS 15 that really do make it a lot better. So as you can see at the top here, you've got a glance of what you've got going on in terms of numbers. So for example, today, scheduled, all, and flagged gives you number options. Within the center here, you've got my lists, and you can create now smart lists, which we'll come into in a moment. And if you created any tags, they appear down at the bottom here now. So let's start with the tags. Tags are really simple. If you've got any tag, you can basically hashtag it as you're typing it out. Anything from groceries, snacks to baking, you can add it all in there. And you can use this narrowing down option too. If you go to the bottom left-hand corner, you can actually create tasks based on chores. So tags can be split up even further, which is quite helpful. So tags show up there and they'll add and grow. And they come into handy when you've got smart lists too, which we'll touch on in a moment. So let's go into today. And as you can see, I've got a few tasks here already. Now, as you can imagine, each of these can be added a lot more detail to in each of the reminders. So here's a little example with record YouTube. I have record YouTube as a title, but I can add notes and URL. I can add the date, the time if I want to, and also when I can have it repeating to and any tags that it's associated to. So in this case, just for this demonstration, I might have work as a tag. And you can add a location and a messaging, for example, to show the notification while you're chatting that person, which is quite helpful because if you create a smart list associated to a bunch of tasks that are with one person, it means that they'll pop up when you're, you know, being able to communicate with that person. So when you're actually in the messaging, oh, remind, you know, my wife about this and that, and it helps you to have that. You can have the priority and list with subtasks down here. Subtasks are a lot harder to get to, but they still are inside, and you can also add images too. So you can see here that I've got a task of record YouTube. Now I actually have this list called priority, and let me just bump it up because it is a little bit more important. So I'm gonna bump it up to the top here. And let me just show you the context around it. What I did is I actually added a custom emoji with a red icon color, and I used the manage smart list function. So you can see here that I've got a relative range. You can choose range of dates to go with a relative range in the next day. So that indicates anything that's going to be in the next day of tasks with a high priority. As you can see down here, I set that. It's going to pick those tasks out. And in this case, if I go into today priority, it brings that up because that is the most important thing I need to do in my day. It really drills it down. Whereas in today, I've got two tasks, which I've used sorting on too. So it's really helpful in particular for being able to plan. One thing you can do as well is I've made this smart list for town. For example, every time I get in my car, you can see that any reminders will pop up. So for example, that's can be set even further. So for example, you know, any tasks that are located elsewhere, you can set the location, but I'm actually gonna add chores as well to see if there's anything associated with that. At the moment there isn't, but if I did have one, for example, it was like my petrol and I put hashtag chores and may press done. Logically, it should come up here, but it doesn't. I obviously need to set the location here to getting in the car. And you can see here there that now that comes through as something to do. So that's quite helpful when it comes to getting in the car, because if in particular got Apple, I think it's CarPlay, you can have the system set up so that when you get in the car, it detects that you're actually in the car and sort of ready to accept new tasks. You can very much have static lists as well. So things that aren't in high level of detail with smart abilities, and you can convert them into smart abilities at any given time. You can also show completed and delete the list too from there. So reminders are a great way to be able to set indications, and you can also use this scheduled coming up to really set the stage for the next week. You can change that about if you want to. And that's how you can really plan ahead with this application. You can also see all of your tasks too, and that breaks it down per project as well. And you can be a bit more modified, especially when sharing tasks with other people, in which you can have assigned to me as something that pops up there too. So that gives you an indication of how many tasks have been assigned to you if you're working with somebody and you're doing this in a light fashion, or you're maybe using this to manage tasks at home. Now, it's really easy to add a new list, bottom right corner. You can do it any given time and can convert it into a smart list. And you can also search globally for any of the tasks that are in your list really easily. Now, Apple Reminders is a free option and it does come with some great abilities. iOS 15 definitely made it easier. They introduced the likes of natural language input as well, and also deleting completed reminders as well, and also upgraded abilities with announcement reminders with Siri. I know, for example, for the fact that I've missed a call this week and it automatically set up time-sensitive notifications and reminders around that, adding it all automatically into my Apple Reminders, which is really helpful. So they're really upgrading this, and they did a few upgrades to Apple Notes as well that you can definitely check out in the link in the description. Anyway, folks, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope it gave you an overview of how to utilize this in, as you can imagine, just as sort of day-to-day management. It's available obviously on Mac as well, and a lot of people like the Mac version too, so it's worth checking out. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll talk to you all very, very soon. Make sure to check out Bento, which is a priority to-do list which helps you to manage your work. It is our application and you can check it out in the link in the description. Can't wait for you guys to check it out. Thank you very much. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.